Ceremony presented by the Hollywood Chamber of Commerce and the Hollywood Historic Trust. We are delighted today to honor one of the music world's most popular female rock bands. As they are honored with the 2,444th star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. Today, Hollywood honors the Go-Go's. Yeah! Belinda Carlisle. Yeah! Charlotte Pappy. Yeah! Gina Schock. Yeah! Kathy Valentine. Yeah! And Jane Wheedler. Yeah! And I've got to tell you, ladies, this is one of the most enthusiastic crowds we've had in a very long time. Now, the Go-Go's are celebrating their recently released and expanded 30th anniversary edition of their double platinum debut album, Beauty and the Beast. They're on the road this summer for their Ladies Gone Wild tour, which will include a stop at Hollywood's Greek Theater on Wednesday, August 17th. How many of you are going to be there? All right. Now, a little bit of trivia for you. The location for the Go-Go Star has special meaning to our honorees. At the corner here is the Betty Page Shop, and that was formerly known as the Mask Nightclub. And this is where the Go-Go's performed for the very first time, May the 31st, 1978. And if you get a chance, check out the windows. Betty Page has done a great job in a salute to the Go-Go's with their display in the window. Now let me tell you a little bit about our honorees, although I know you all know this, but we have to repeat it for the press. From their halcyon days as America's sweethearts to their current status as superstars who pioneered a genre, the Go-Go's preside over an amazing three-decade reign as high pop priestesses. The internationally loved pop hit makers helped cement the foundation of the early 1980s pop rock sound without the aid of outside composers, session players, or, more importantly, creative compromise. From their very first show at this very site, the Go-Go's sang and played their own songs, offering five feisty role models for a generation of ready-to-rock girls and good, fun-loving, pop-loving guys. Yeah! Their story is truly, truly a punk version of the American dream. Yeah! They came, they saw, and they conquered the charts, the airwaves, and with their kicky kitsch appeal, pop culture in general. At the time, the band was virtually inescapable. TV guest shots, magazine covers, high-profile concert tours, and movie offers turned the ladies into certified rock stars. Yes. Their sparkling California pop appealed to an astonishingly wide cross-section of music fans internationally. Now, because of, or maybe in spite of all this attention, they soared to become a pop phenomenon while having a lot of fun and blazing a brand new trail for the do-it-yourself ethic in general and for women in music in particular. Their self-contained battle cry was a string of irresistibly catchy self-penned pop singles featuring Belinda's infectious vocals, with Charlotte and Jane's loud punk rock guitars and sweet backing vocals, all slammed home with Kathy's throbbing bass and Gina's big 60s beat. Sure, before the Go-Go's debuted in May of 1978, there were other all-female bands, but this group shaped their own image and wrote their own songs. They did it all themselves. Now, by 1979, the Go-Go's were beating their path to stardom on their own terms. They played every cool club and party in L.A., and naturally, record companies were starting to sniff around. Still, the band remained to their punk leanings, releasing an early version of We Got the Beat through Stiff Records in the U.K. As 1980 turned into 1981, the band was signed to upstart IRS Records. As summer arrived, so did Beauty and the Beat. Hot on the heels of their debut U.S. single, Our Lips Are Sealed. Summer turned to fall and the world fell in love with the Go-Go's. The double platinum certified Beauty and the Beat reached number one. And it begat Vacation in 1982. And Talk Show in 1984, during the ladies' charming reign of chart and radio smashes. And like any truly classic rock band, their enduring hits including Vacation. I hear you. Head Over Heels. And Turn to You. Live on in countless compilations, movie soundtracks, remakes, and yes, even a string of very successful television commercials. The Go-Go's are involved in numerous charities, including the Revlon Breast Cancer Run Walk, PETA, the Humane Society, Little Kids Rock, the Girl Scouts of America, and the George Harrison Fund for UNICEF's Month of Giving this very month. The whole world may have lost its head, but in a world gone crazy, the Go-Go's still have the beat. And now, 3 decades after the release of their first album, Go-Go music still makes us dance, and the Go-Go's are getting their star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. Now, here to help us celebrate today, we have a few guests. Our first speaker is a world-renowned drummer. In the mid-1970s, he answered an ad for a high-energy drummer. The band in question was Blondie. Yeah. He has worked with many artists and bands, including Bob Dylan, Pete Townshend, Iggy Pop, The Ramones, Checkered Past, The Romantics, Joan Jett, and The Eurythmics. He was just honored, and get this, with an honorary doctorate of music by the University of Gloucestershire for his groundbreaking involvement in the Clem Burke drumming project. Please welcome Dr. Clem Burke.
Hello and good morning. I'd like to say it's an honor to be here today. And we all know why we're here, so I'm going to go ahead and tell you, as Leron just did, but I will reiterate some things and then carry on with some of my own observations. The Go-Go's are a band that came together here on the streets of Los Angeles with a do-it-yourself attitude that saw them playing at local punk rock clubs like the one we're in front of today, The Mask, before moving on to places like the Whiskey A Go-Go and the Starwood. From there, they went to such venues as the Greek Theater, which we're going to see them on August 17th, right? Yeah! Unsolicited plug. Okay, and to Madison Square Garden. I, for one, witnessed a career-defining performance at Madison Square Garden, with the Go-Go's opening for the Police, while the Go-Go's album, Beauty and the Beat, was number one in the Billboard charts. Suffice to say, they held their own that night in what was an exciting and pivotal performance by a great rock and roll band, the Go-Go's. The Go-Go's define what it means to be a great band. Fantastic songwriting, charismatic front person, swinging anchor solid drummer, great vocal harmonies and several multi-talented instrumentalists all within this self-contained group of people. Belinda, Charlotte, Gina, Jane, and Kathy are seminal, groundbreaking artists, combining such diverse influences as surf music, girl group, punk rock, rockabilly, Mercy Beat, and Motown to make a sound that is truly their own. In closing, I would like to say congratulations to the Go-Go's from all their fans around the world. And I look forward to what rightly should be your next induction into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Yeah. It's an honor to be here today. Peace and love to everyone.
Yes.
Everybody, rock on, man. See ya.
Thank you, Doctor. Let me acknowledge the chairman of the board of the Hollywood Chamber of Commerce here in the suit, Marty Shelton. Now, the Chamber of Commerce administers the Walk of Fame on behalf of the City of Los Angeles, and we couldn't honor these wonderful ladies and this group without having the city make a presentation. So on behalf of the President of the Los Angeles City Council, Eric Garcetti, please welcome Mitch O'Farrell.
Thanks, Laron. Does everyone remember this album? When I moved here in January of 1982 in Hollywood, this album cover was plastered all over Hollywood. And I thought, what's this group about? And then I realized that incredibly wonderful song, Our Lips Are Sealed, was off of this album. And that is a timeless classic. To this day, the council member, myself, the whole staff, to cheer ourselves up, I'll put on the YouTube video of Our Lips Are Sealed, and it works every time. So on behalf of the City of Los Angeles, we have passed a resolution honoring Belinda Carlisle, Jane Wiedlin, Charlotte Caffey, Gina Schock, Kathy Valentine, congratulating the Go-Go's on this well-deserved honor of receiving their own star on the world-famous Hollywood Walk of Fame. They each get one of these wonderful certificates as a token of our appreciation for making millions and millions of people across the world happy all these years. Thank you. Please come up.
All right, Gina!
The right album.